Let's talk about your portfolio and how we can export it at the highest quality possible while maintaining a very low file size. At first, it may seem like a really complicated process, but if you're anything like me, it was probably due a week ago. So I'm gonna go through the steps quickly with no BS. If you enjoyed the video, please like the video and make sure to stick around until the end because I threw in a little InDesign tip.
Right now I have my portfolio open in InDesign. It's about 32 pages long. It's a pretty large portfolio and I have a lot of large images in it. So let's try to compress this down to somewhere around 5 megabytes. Most firms, I would say, have a limit to your portfolio size at around 20 megabytes. Getting it below 10 megabytes is great, and I've even done some applications where the maximum was 5 megabytes. So let's aim for anywhere between 5 megabytes to 10 megabytes. First things first, let's go up to File, down to Adobe PDF Presets, and over to High Quality Print. I'm going to name this Architecture Portfolio 1. And I'm going to save it to my desktop. Click Save. All right, so now we're in the export settings. Compatibility, you can leave at Acrobat 5. Some firms use an older Adobe Acrobat program to view their PDFs. And I have my portfolio designed as spreads, so I'm going to click Spreads, but you may have yours designed as pages. Feel free to click Pages. And over here on the left-hand side, you can see marks, bleeds, output, advanced, security, and summary. Lucky for us, we don't have to worry about any of those. The only two tabs we're going to focus on is general and compression. So let's head over to the compression tab. So when you first come over to the compression tab, it looks very confusing. I mean, look at all these numbers, and what do they mean? Well, it's actually quite simple. What this is doing, it's compressing your images above 450 pixels per inch down to 300 pixels per inch. And pixels per inch can actually be abbreviated as PPI. A lot of times you've probably heard of DPI, that's dots per inch. That's more for printers and physical media. PPI, or pixels per inch, is for digital media. So previously the industry standard was 72 PPI, but a lot of displays these days run anywhere between 200 to 500 PPI. So let's go ahead and start at 300 PPI here, and InDesign will automatically set this as 450. You can set 300 PPI for the grayscale images as well. Let's go ahead and click Export. Okay, now our export is complete. Let's go ahead and head to the desktop and check it out. Wow, it's a whopping 44 megabytes. That's way too high for me, so let's go back and try it again. Go to File, Adobe PDF Presets, and over to High Quality Print. I'm going to name this one Architecture Portfolio 2. Try not to save over your first one, just in case. Click Save. I'm going to set mine to Spreads. Once again, if yours is designed as Pages, set yours to Pages. And let's head over to the Compression tab. So the best way to get your portfolio to a megabyte that's acceptable to you is to decrease this PPI in 50 PPI increments. So I'm going to set this to 250. And as you can see, InDesign changed this automatically, so you don't have to worry about those numbers. And click Export. Okay, now that our export is done, let's go to the desktop and check it out once again. It compressed it down to 32.9 megabytes, which is about 11 megabytes smaller than the previous version. Okay, let's head back into InDesign for the last time. We're going to go to File, Adobe PDF Presets, High Quality Print. I'm going to name this one Architecture Portfolio 3. And click Save. I'm going to click Spreads and go over to Compression. I know from the last export that 150 probably still won't be small enough, So I'm going to go ahead and set it to 100. Now, if you'd like, you can decrease your image quality. I always do that as a last resort if it's maybe 1 or 2, possibly 3 megabytes off. This can help out a little bit. But I definitely wouldn't go below medium because your images will start to look grainy. So leave it at maximum and hit export. All right, so now that it's done, let's go ahead to the desktop and check it out. 8.76 megabytes, that's perfect. That's within the 10 megabyte threshold I was looking for. Let's go ahead and check out the image quality. Oh, we gotta zoom out just a little bit. There we go. All right, great, that works for me. All right, so now for that quick tip. Let's go ahead and add a new spread in here. Zoom in. You can center the page with Control 0. Now, a lot of times in InDesign, you're creating multiple frames, and let's say you want a grid of about 3x3. A lot of people would make one, copy, paste it, and align it. Then they would do that again. But that just takes too much time. So, grab your rectangle frame tool, click and drag it to the size you would want your grid to be, and use your arrow keys. And there you have it. InDesign automatically makes the grid for you. All right, thanks for watching, y'all. If you enjoyed the video, please like the video and consider subscribing down below to see future content. Are you doing the outro with me? Yeah. You cutie pie. You're okay. Do you like this? Like this. Oh. I shouldn't have done that.